Hey, what's up everybody around the world? Welcome back to another tutorial in Revit's Global Knowledge. Today I'm going to show you how to create a cool looking public sitting area design in Revit. As you can see, here is my project reference before we jumping into our project. We got some concrete wall and here is our public sitting area goes through our work as my thumbnail review and as my project reference as you can see here. So I think I will guide you from start to finish. Okay, if you are looking closely as you can see here, our wood panel is running properly. Same line here is the arch here then looking properly. So now I think it's pretty much for intro use. So let's speak into our project together. And this is your first time reaching out here, make sure thumbs up, like and share and subscribe if you are first time reaching out here. Okay, so now let's speak into our project together. Here is my project reference. Now I want to transfer to level one. This level one here is my new and another Revit architecture template. So what I'm going to do first to achieve my public sitting area design, so I'm going to create some reference plan first. RP for shortcut key, then just start from here like this, then just type out for number one, then hit escape, open up my sound elevation. Then I will keep reminding for level two. So we're using for model in place, go to architecture tab, model in place. Then I just drop down finding for wall. It's okay. It's okay again. Once I done that, I'm going to create some extrusion first. Set a plan. Then set for reference plan 1. It's okay. Okay, simply using for rectangle, I just start something like this. And make this guy is a exact size. Just make it for 12 meter. Hit escape a couple time. Then I just hit finish up. Once I done that, I need to finish my setting up first. I need to setting this for 4 meter. And of course, I need to create a new material as well. This one, I will be make it for concrete, create new material, then just rename it for concrete. Then I can go to my appearance library. I want some kind of block. I like this guy over there, concrete cast in place. So I can apply. As you can see, the texture here is got separate panel, is quite nice. So I can hit OK. Once I done that, I can go to my create tab again, then using our void, or I can select my existing extrusion, just like here, then edit our extrusion. So what I'm going to do next, I'm going to using a line, then I will start high for 300 millimeter from the bottom. Then I will come here 300, hit escape, then come here about 1.2 meter. Yep, hit escape. Then I just continue make it for 1.5 and I think we make it something like this. Yep, then coming up 500, then again make this one align for the bottom one, just make it like this. Then I will make it for 1 meter, 45 degree. And there is 45 degree as 115 degree as well, 1 meter, and just coming up about 600, then like this. Then I can escape TR for trim and extend. Then this guy over there will be delete. Once I done that, I just hit finish. As you can see here, now I got my concrete wall opening. So what I'm going to do next, I'm going to create tab, then go to void using void extrusion. Sorry, I should be using for extrusion name, then same reference plan 1. Okay, then I just offset this one for 100 millimeter for thickness. Just do a pick line. I'm going to pick here. And of course here I need to draw it out first. Let me start from here. Okay, I think something like this. Make it like this, hit escape. Then I'm going to pick here. Just pick here, offset for 100. Let me hit escape first. I'm going to delete there first. Then I'm going to copy that, just CO for copy. make it up for 100, hit escape, then I'm going to pick again, just simply pick here. The rule to create extrusion, you may need to create solid, only you can achieve that, hit escape, then I'm going to trim and extend here, sorry, so I can connect it that. TR for trim and extend. As you can see here, now it's done perfectly. Once I done that, what I'm going to do next, I'm going to assign for a new material first. For this one, I'm going to create for orange color, spray paint or paint, orange, go to our Assist browser again, open apparent library, then using for wall paint, then I'm going to using for orange color, this guy over there, apply, hit finish, then I can finish again. Okay, once I done that, I can go to my create tab again, use our extrusion again, and name, then pick for reference plane again, hit okay. Okay, perfect. Now I'm going to use same as before, just pick our object, offset for 100, then I pick my object here. Just follow my previous process. Then the offset will be make it for 0. Then here will be connected. Then here will be connected again. Hit escape. Once I done that, I'm going to hit finish. Then I'm going to assign for new material as well. Create new material for orange. It's okay. Once I done that, let me select my existing first. This guy over there, I will make it for orange. It's okay. And this guy over there, I'm going to assign you, create new material, make this one for wood. It's okay. Go to my appearance library or go to my family type there. I will change my wood there to a new family material, create new, then rename it for wood panel. Go to our appearance library again. Then I'm going to finding for wood. Just drop down finding what wood is fit to map to my design here. I'm going to using for ox here. Apply, hit finish. Apply, it's okay. Okay, once I done that, let me check first. Okay, perfect. Again, perfect. Go to our create tab, use void extrusion. Name, then set a reference plane, hit okay. Okay, obviously before I using void extrusion, I just draw it out before I make a tutorial. I try to using for beam system or using concept to mask, using mask with our adaptive component to create our beam wood panel here, but not fake is will be take time when you use that. That's why I suggestion using my main thought here is create your existing solid extrusion first. Only you create your void extrusion to cut that. This is my suggestion because I have tried out already before I product my tutorial. My tutorial is just want to let you know how fast you can do that and how easy you can using it to model your project. This is my style. I want things easy and faster and perfect. This is the reason I create Revit tutorial. So if you like that, make sure hit subscribe because it motivates me to bring more professional content and bring the next level for Revit tutorial for you guys. Okay, so now let's continue. I think I talked to my already, so I'm going to continue that. Then I'm going to offset here about 100. Just draw here, hit a tab key, and again I'm going to draw it again. Let me change this one to 0 first. Then I'm going to connect that. Just make it for 10. Then connect it. Okay, perfect. Okay, this one wrong already. Obviously, LI for line, TR for trim and extend. Perfect. Now I think I need to copy that. I won't switch this model. Basically, it's another YouTuber. He do that content creator. They will speak this part, but I just find out if I skip this part for some subscriber or some learner. They want to follow my step. They will have leads to saw that, and they need to slow down the speed from YouTube. This is the reason I won't skip all my tutorial. I just make it natural. Hit aspect key, then this one you can extend for make it accurate. Then I can pick here again, just pick here, then make it for 10 every like this. Then I just connect it. This is the reason I never speak my tutorial, speak it more fast. I think slowly is better than you don't know anything. You watch this, then you could not use this in your future. We are human, we are different perspective actually. So just try. You can skip here a couple minutes, also can. And we'll make it for 100. Yep, perfect. Just offset there every 100. Follow along together for every step. I will guide you from beginner level to expert level. The reason I create this channel because I want to share my knowledge about Revit design. I thought it's helped out, and as you know, I am from Southeast Asia, so my English not very well like Europe. So I try to talk in English because it is easier for you guys understand what I am saying. If I talk my own language will be hardy for you guys. That's why I just talk it out like this. So I hope you don't mind my accent. So I'm going to use it again. Then offset for 100. As you can see here, it's quite fast and easy. So I will try it out for 10. Then follow, just start from here. Then connect it. Hit escape. Okay, this guy over there, we wrong already. Sorry. So I'm going to use our line, connect it again. Okay, perfect. I'm going to continue to copy that. Perfect. So again, we offset for 100 again. We could not using array tool in this kind of situation. As you can see here, make sure you make your offset is 0. Okay, this guy wrong already. Make it for 10, hit escape. I'm going to connect it. Then again, I will copy that. Make it constraint. Just tie it out 100. Okay, sorry, I tried wrong already. Click all again. See all for copy. Then going to copy from here until here. Make it 100. Just tie it out 100. Your B will be automatically, as you can see here. Basically, I want to using array tool, but they don't allow me in this situation. That's why I need to copy that. Okay, wrong already. Come on. Okay, perfect. So we got another few more. TR for trim and extend. CO for copy. I'm going to copy until here. 100. Just follow it. Okay, this one is to my RD. Okay, in some time I hardly to figure out, I will start from here. Okay, I'm going to copy again. Start from here until to unconstrain first. Okay, 100. But you can see here it's running properly. I just type out the number, hit escape. Okay, another 2 step more to finish our tutorial. Okay, this guy will be deleted. Copy again. Hit escape, then this one I'm going to copy again. Okay, I think it's perfectly. So what I'm going to do next, I just hit finish and make this one is 4 meter. Apply, then hit, let's see this guy over there. I need to offset for 4 meter, and this guy over there we need to make extrusion and is 4 meter also. Apply. Okay, so I just hit, let me adjustment this one first, make it like this. Finish, go to our 3D there. As you can see here, our wood panel is running properly and the joining here is quite nice. As you can see here, if you are using for beam system or using your model massing and size will be cause facing some problem there, so you will be need to create some extrusion to fix that. So if you are using still using extrusion, why you don't using all the set using by extrusion, I think using solid extrusion is better in this situation. When I turn on to realistic, you will see together, as you can see here, it's quite nice, it's quite perfectly. Okay guys, I think it's pretty much for Saturday tutorial. Thank you for watching and thank you for joining me from start to finish. If you like this tutorial, make sure to thumbs up, like and share. And if you are first time reaching out here, make sure to hit subscribe button below and turn off for all notifications so you won't miss my future tutorial. Okay guys, it's pretty much thank you for watching and I see you for another tutorial in Revis, and have a nice weekend. Thank you.